Many in Houston were shocked, some were angered, some were surprised, but I certainly was not, by the comments by Bob McNair in regards to NFL players, where he says inmates running the prison, and you and I both know it's inmates running the asylum. That's how the saying goes. But at the end of the day, they were offended because just a week earlier, Roger Goodell and one of the player reps from the NFL signed a letter sent to the House Judiciary Committee about revisiting sentencing guidelines that has adversely affected many African-American young black men in this country, then turned right around and Bob McNair referred to the NFL players as prisoners.
Wind me a river. It's an old expression. Look, I don't know what's going on, but now you could say, like, the sky is sort of bluish green and there's some black folks who get offended. There was nothing about race. Nothing about race. And let me tell you something. The fans are sending a message, Quan. There are legitimate things about police brutality in the minority community. But this whole flag thing, this whole national anthem thing, it ain't working. The stadium is half empty.
But remember, Dwayne, this was not about really anything other than protesting police misconduct, excessive use of force, and unarmed black men being killed by police officers, what we believe is unjustly. So that's what Colin Kaepernick took a knee about. It was never about offending, disrespecting America's first responders or our servicemen and women. When you listen to the national anthem, Wayne, listen to the third verse where it says, no refuge or no peace shall be given to a slave or a black person in America. That's what that anthem was talking about. So why shouldn't we take a knee when something like that is being played?
Okay, so you know I'm a big history buff. I've actually gone back and read that third imaginary verse that's not in there. I've read that verse. Look, at the time, the British didn't have enough troops, so they hired some mercenaries, they hired some slaves to fight. That's all it was talking about. There were slaves there, and they were killed, and it's history. One of my big
concerns... But here's the problem. You had slaves fighting for America's freedom, and when America won her freedom in the Independence War, we didn't get ours. When America fought the Civil War, black men fought on the side of the North and the South. But when she got theirs, we didn't really get ours. We got it in language, but not in deed. So when you say, cry me a river, black folk not crying, Wayne. We're standing up saying, make America better and live up to our values.
And I'm with you on that. But the way to get there, we have made so much progress. Why all of a sudden we are being inserted,
Wayne,
back to the Civil War, I just don't
Wayne,
know.
Wayne, a few have made progress, but the masses of black people are still suffering. And I'm sorry, sir, no white gentleman like yourself has the right or the moral right to tell black people how we should direct our fight
I
or
totally
how we
agree.
Should pursue it, because we are the victims of racism, certainly not you and your people.
I totally agree. Well, as you know, I'm half Jewish, so my people were slaves
discussion.
Too. Well, no, it's not, because... And as horrible as it is, this world, men in this world, have enslaved others, black and white.
And women.
And women, for thousands of years.